working out at, where are we again? Good Life. Good Life.
Home turf.
With this guy. Still ignore him. And Philesthetics. And Jen. This guy's eating a banana in the gym.
Pre-workout. I'm all natty, see?
Okay, no, he says he's all natty. Chest day today, he said. I don't think y'all heard him. This man has a soft voice. Soft voice.
Chest day for Jen?
Chest day for Jen.
So we're out here working out while Jen's holding the camera.
You need to film, you gotta do more than 2.5 pounds.
I know, right?
Seriously. And you got big muscles too, man.
What's up, everyone? It's Phil back here, just doing a grocery haul. Got some lettuce. That should be good. Greek yogurt is also a must for your diet, especially if you're a sweets person. It kills that sweet tooth of yours, and it has really good macros as well. Right here, I get half a cup, 125 grams for 120 calories, 16 carbs, and 10 grams of protein for 14 grams of sugar. So again, this still has, you still have to watch what you eat, but this is a lot better in macros than eating, let's say, chocolate or chips or something like that to kill your hunger, or sorry, your cravings. Quakers or any of the rice cakes are really good for just, you know, killing that hunger. This one's 50 calories per rice cake with 1 gram of protein and 11 grams of carbs. It's a lot better than a lot of snacks out there. And if you like more flavor, just go with one of them crispy minis with a little bit better flavor. What I like to eat for my cuts are, where are them goldfish? My go-to snacks when I'm craving something really salty like chips, because the macros for 34 crackers of goldfish, you have 100 calories, 4.5 fats, 2 grams of protein, 12 grams of carbs. So even if you eat 34 of these, like, just, you know, don't kill it all at one time. It's good to kill that salty craving. Very good. Sorry?
Did you buy two?
Yeah, I bought two.
Oh.
Yeah. Enjoy, it's good. Yeah, I was standing there. She was asking me about Greek yogurt and the macros on Greek yogurt. So yeah, it's good to always help with people. Hey there, guys. It's Phil here coming in from my car. I'm just stuck in traffic right now. I'm gonna go pick up Jen from Sunnybrook Hospital. She works at Sunnybrook Hospital as a radiation therapist student. And I wasn't sure what the radiation therapist did at the beginning as well, but I think the best way to describe it is like oncology. Yeah, she's working as a student. I'm very proud of her. She's doing her placement there right now. She started and she's really liking it. I don't know. I don't know if I can do anything like that. It takes a lot of studying. She studies like every night. She can go for like 24 hours. I don't know how she does it. You know, when I open a book, I start to yawn. I asked her why she chose this field, and she answered me, she just wants to really help people. So radiation therapy basically is treating cancer patients with radiation, different types of tools and everything like that. That's what she's studying. Kind of actually a really dangerous job. being exposed to that much radiation. And I asked her one day, I asked her, why did you choose radiation therapy out of any other field? She says she wants to help people, genuinely help people. And that's what that's what gives her motivation to succeed in the field. And I think that's what a lot of people need in this world. It's just the motivation. These days, most people just sit around drinking, smoking weed, doing drugs or whatnot. Look like losers to me, you know, like, and they make fun of all those people that work really hard to achieve their goals. Like, it doesn't, everybody has different goals, you know. You don't have to be like a movie star or, you know, a singer. Like, everyone has their own goals and paths, and it's, that's what life is, right? Choosing the different paths to take to achieve your goals. And don't be afraid to take risks. A lot of people are afraid to take risks. What can you lose at this time right now? You're in your young 20s or, you know, early 20s or teens, graduating out of university. What's the rush on, you know, settling down, doing the family stuff? It's like basically the best time to go out there and take risks. You can't lose. Like, what can you possibly lose if you go out there and try to achieve your goals and you fail? Let's say you go bankrupt today. You're probably poor anyways, right? Coming out of university, there's no downfall of trying right now. For example, driving. Let's say you're driving down, you just got your license and you're always speeding, right? You're taking a risk, you're always speeding. You're gonna be speeding down the highway, you know, 140, doesn't matter what it is. You're gonna be taking that risk every time. It's just like coming out of school, you can take those risks, people do it. And when you fail, when you get caught from the police and you get that first speeding ticket, you'll learn not to ever speed again, right? It's just like if you fail in a business or a goal that you're trying to achieve, you're gonna do it again. But this time you're gonna learn from the experience and do it properly. Just like when people are gonna start driving, after getting that speeding ticket, they're gonna drive according to speed limit. They're not gonna speed anymore, or maybe not for a little bit, but they're not gonna speed anymore. They're gonna always have that mentality, oh, you can get caught, because they learn from that mistake, right? That's just like applying anything to your mindset, your goals, right? Go after it, take those risks, and don't be scared to fail. Guys, who are you gonna wait for? Like, I hear so many people say, oh yeah, they're gonna start their diet tomorrow. Oh no, I'm gonna start this tomorrow. No, I'm gonna do that tomorrow. Why you gotta wait till tomorrow? Why don't you start it now? Like, what's stopping you from doing it now? Go get it today. You know, what's the point of waiting? You know, the more time you wait, you know, life is short. Go out there and make mistakes. Go get your hands dirty. You know, why are you being so I hate a lot of people who are really shy about what they do. You know, spend all day just pondering or thinking about what they can do, or planning. You know, you can only do so much planning. What's the point of planning if you don't execute? You have to execute. You know, it's better to execute first than plan later after you make those mistakes, so you actually know what you're doing. You have that gut, or you have the bravery now to go and execute, you know? Don't just sit around smoking weed or drinking or whatnot. Go and achieve your dreams, or go and achieve your goals, you know? I hate those people who tell me every day they don't have time to do this, they don't have time to do that, but they have time to freaking lounge around their couch or freaking watch TV all day. I hate that. You know, why are you making up excuses? Every single day, it could be a passing moment that, you know, there's opportunities. You gotta take those opportunities, you know, don't let them go. Don't be scared. You know, opportunities might come once in a lifetime, you know, twice in a lifetime, you never know. Take every single one of them. It's a numbers game. The more opportunities you take, you know, the easier it is, or the more chance you have of succeeding. You know, even if you don't succeed, you learn from every single one of those times you try. Every single one of those opportunities you get that you try, you learn from them, right? And you are already that much further. You've taken the steps already to be, you know, closer to your goals than those people who don't. You know, those people who sit around, lounge around, you know, if you want to start a clothing line, you're saying there's too many clothing lines out there. How do you know how successful your clothing line is if you don't go out there and try it? You don't go out there and put yourself out there and try. You might have a better product than most people. You might have something people desire that you might not know about right now. But you'll never know if you don't give it a try. Then comment down below. Let me know what kind of goals you have, you know, what kind of dreams you want to achieve, how people put you down, or how people encourage you, or how you plan on achieving this goal.